common areas that I was seeing on the day, so you should have part of that being ready to work with me, like you have your notes out, go. Okay? So I'm giving you an example of the kind of mistake that I would see. Okay, I want you to explain the mistake that you really have made. Let's just start with that. Just on your notes, explain what it is, what mistake you see that Lilia has made. If you're not sure, if you think like, no, that looks good, then you should really pay attention, because it seems like maybe you're making this kind of mistake as well. Okay? So you want to pay close attention. You do not think there's an error here. Okay, let's take a quick vote. It should be one or the other. It's an error in one of these things. There's just two terms here. Raise your hand if you feel like the error is here. Raise your hand if you feel like the error is here. Okay. Who would like to explain to us what the heck is going on here? Jacqueline?
Well, I said that since it's -5 + 9, you'd actually be basically subtracting, so it wouldn't be 14.
So it wouldn't be 14?
Yeah.
Okay. What would it be?
I got 4.
Well, not just 4, right?
4x,
good. Because this is -5x + 9x. Okay? I see a lot, way too much of 5 plus 9. 5x plus 9x is 14x. Well, that's true. 5x plus 9x is 14x. But this isn't 5x. What is it?
Negative 5x.
Okay? Be careful about that. See that too much. Enough that it's worth bringing up to everybody. Okay? So be careful. When you see this, make sure you're paying attention to this sign right there, because it matters. Okay? This part of the equation, or this part of the expression is saying -5x + 9x, right? If we didn't have anything else to start from, we could look at a number line. Oh, actually, that's the next thing that I wanted you to do. So I want you to, in your notes, draw a number line, use a number line to help Lilia see why she's made a mistake and how she can fix that mistake. A second. Okay, so how do we use a number line to show Lilia what's up here? Lily?
Yeah, so put 0 in the middle.
All right, we'll throw a 0 there.
And then you put +9, so to the right.
Okay, I'm going to put 9x, okay, because it all works the same.
And then you can like, go back 5 times.
Go back 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
-4x.
So if we went back 5, starting from 9, we'd be at
positive
4. It's not really to scale. I didn't do that very well. But there we are. X, Tiana. I bet Tiana wants me to draw this again,
mm-hmm.
And then wants to say why.
Okay, so I did it differently because
okay.
5 is the first number is where you start out at.
Okay.
And you start out at -5.
So we'll put this guy at to the left of 0, -5.
Uh-huh, and then I counted 9 over 4.
Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gets us to 0, mm-hmm. 6, 7, 8, 9, and...
Yeah.
Also at 4x. Both ways completely, perfectly correct. Very good. Doubly good. Okay. So whether we think it as 9x minus 5x or -5x plus 9x, we're still going to wind up where?
4x.
Okay, so careful about that. What you're really doing there is you're going out of order. You're going out of the order of operations. You're adding before you subtract. If you subtracted first, it would look kind of like this. We would subtract, we'd be back here at -5x, then we'd add 9x, that would take us all the way up here to 4x. Yeah.
But you aren't able to subtract because they're not like terms.
Right, so I can't subtract 5x from -18, right? But I can kind of treat it as its own little thing. And that's like, this is its own little thing, makes it -18. This would be its own little thing, right? And if we... But if there's nothing there, we would just start at 0, go back 5x, go forward 9x, and be at 4x. Okay, next one. Let's take a look here. This is actually done correctly because there's so many different errors here that I don't want to concentrate on any one. I just want to show you and remind you what is correct. correct. Okay, so here's an example of correct work. Let's take a look at it and answer this question. In the purple step, what did Greg do to help himself avoid mistakes in combining like terms?
I'm gonna call him JC. She seems
ready to go. Is that true?
Yeah.
Okay.
He moved around like terms to be next to each other so that it would be easier for him to solve the problem.
Okay, so he moved like terms next to each other. That what you said? Like terms next to each other. The thing that the mistake that happens here a lot is that you don't pay attention to the signs. The sign of 5x is a negative. It's a negative 5x. Okay. I don't know why, but sometimes I'll see like a negative 5, right, as the constant. How does this person wind up with a negative 5? I'm talking about like this, the x term, like, I don't know, maybe the x term they get an 8x. This is a response I've seen many times, 8x minus 5. Zach, what's going on here?
They did subtraction for, they did 4 subtracted by 9.
Why did they do that?
Well,
I guess so. Yeah, that's my guess. I'm guessing they saw minus and they said minus 9. Careful, like if the negative is there and it's attached to just a single term, then it carries with that single term.
Wait, what did you do right there?
This person did not make a mistake. This person did great work, got the correct answer here. But this is an example of an error that I might see. They kind of ignore the negative, or maybe they misassign the negative to the 9. I don't know what's going on. It's hard to say what this person did, because, well, their work wasn't in that much detail, so I don't know exactly what they were doing. Even then, they would have to like write it out in words. This is what I was thinking, and I don't expect you to do that. So I'm kind of guessing at what people are doing. I'm not sure why this happens. But if you want to, like Greg, help yourself out, move the like terms next to each other and make sure that the signs follow the term around that they started with. Okay? This starts out negative. It's always going to be negative. Negative 5x, negative 5x. 3x minus 5x, negative 2x. Great. 4 plus 9. 4 plus 9, 13. Make sure that the sign follows the term that it started with. Okay? Yeah, okay. We kind of already answered this. Sometimes people will maybe swap these around, the 4 and the negative 5x, like Greg did here, but the 5x will become positive and the 4 will become negative. That might be The reason I bring this up is primarily because of positive and negative issues. Okay. Make sure the negatives follow the terms that they started with, the positives follow the terms they started with, and not mix those up. Okay. So in the blue step, in your notes, write briefly what it is that Buck has done incorrectly. All right, Kaden?
What are numerals?
Numerals are just like numbers, like the number 4. But the word 4 is not a numeral. The number is not a numeral. Does that make sense?
They multiplied 4 by the numbers in parentheses when you had to subtract.
So you shouldn't distribute that 4, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And so how do you know you're not supposed to do that?
Because it had a minus 1. Okay.
Negative there, yes. There's a negative right there. There's it's minus, right? It's 4 minus. What's distribution for? Like, when do we distribute? Distribution is 4. It's a word that starts with M.
Multiplication.
Multiplication is 4 being multiplied by the parentheses.
No.
It is not. What is being multiplied by the parentheses?
1.
A negative 1. Okay. A negative 1. Okay. So what mistake is blue? Does Buck make it blue? He distributes the 4. Distributes 4. Shouldn't be doing that. Actually, distributes a negative 4. Got it. Or kind of does? Yeah, I don't know. There's no right answer because it's wrong. So how does he do it? I don't know. It's not right. So using the word no numerals, I just mean like write the number. If you're going to say 4, write at who you are, not write the number 4. So could someone just read this out verbatim, word for word? Dalton?
4 minus 1 times 5x plus 7.
That's pretty good. 4 minus 1 times, maybe parentheses, 5x plus 7, end parentheses. Maybe we could say that. So if we were to distribute, what would it sound like instead? It would sound like 4. What would be the next word?
Goes into
times.
Times would be the next word we would say. 4 times the parentheses. We don't say that. It's not 4 times 4. It's not being multiplied. We're subtracting the stuff in the parentheses from 4. Right? So if we wanted to do this correctly, we would distribute a negative 1. Like we're subtracting everything in the parentheses. So I need to subtract 5x. I need to subtract a 7. Let's make sure we're not making positive and negative errors. How would I combine these, and what would this look like if I simplified combining like terms here? Brennan? Somebody new, maybe? Avery?
You would, or you could move, or you could change, or move them.
Okay, move what?
So the 4 and the negative 7.
And how would you move them?
So it makes sense.
Negative 7 plus 4, like that?
Yeah, and then minus 5x.
All right, very good. Yeah, that's exactly correct. I mean, the order is not important. I can put negative 5x first, whatever, doesn't matter. But now I put the like terms next to each other, so I'm less likely to get confused when these things up. So we have
3, or
negative 3, very good.
Minus 5x.
I saw a lot of those errors, you know, like negative 7 plus 4. I saw negative 7 plus 4 is 11. Negative 7 plus 4 is 3. Negative 7 plus 4, those are probably the two common errors there. It's negative 3, right? Okay, I think I have. Okay, let me make sure my speakers are turned up. Sure, turn the lights off real quick if you would. Hey, this is not extra credit material here.
Talking as you're waiting, not necessary.
Oh, you did. There you go.
Okay, let's see if I can it's in the right place. That's about, no way. Is this gonna work?
Hail them. Bye.
Oh, hey, ma'am, one more thing.
Yes.
When you come to this drink, swim through it, not over it.
Trench, through it, not over it. I'll remember. Hey, hey, hey! Hey, wait up, partner! Hold on! Wait! I gotta tell you something. Whoa. Nice trench. Hello! Okay, let's go.
Bad trench. Come on, we're gonna swim over this thing.
Whoa, partner. Little red flag going up. Something's telling me we should swim through it, not over it.
Are you even looking at this thing? It's got death written all over it.
I'm sorry, but I really, really, really think we should swim through.
And I'm really, really done talking about this. Over we go.
Come on, trust me on this.
Trust you?
Yes, trust. It's what friends do.
Look, something shiny.
Where?
Oh, it just swam over the trench. Come on, we're following.
Okay. Boy, sure is clear up here.
Exactly. And look at that. There's the current. We should be there in no time.
Hey, little guy.
You wanted to go through the trench.
I shall call him Squishy, and he shall be mine, and he shall be my Squishy. Come here, Squishy. Come here, little Squishy.
Ow! Dory, that's a jellyfish!
Bad Squishy.
Shoot, get it. Come here, let me see.
Don't touch it.
Don't touch it. I just want to look.
Hey, how come it didn't sting you?
It did. It's just that I was still. I live in the Sunemone, and I'm used to these kind of stings. Come here.
Ow.
It doesn't look bad. You're gonna be fine. But now we know, don't we? That we don't want to touch these again. Let's be thankful this time it was just a little one.
Okay. So, what's the moral?
Listen to what people say and trust your friends.
Every problem. That's okay. Easy.
We're pushing a little hard to jump ahead. So the moral for Neat for Marlin and
don't
Dory.
Don't go through the trench. Don't
go through
over.
The trench. Okay. So in an algebra class or in a math class, what might be the trench?
To go through it.
What's that?
The
don't
equation.
Skip over
yeah.
And do it and
try
it yeah.
First.
Not the problem exactly, but maybe the way we solve the problem.
Yes.
Right?
Don't take the shortcut.
Don't take a shortcut.
Actually,
what you
think
is a shortcut. Turns out, going through the trench is the shortcut.
Because it was like, and don't touch baby Jilly.
Don't touch
grown-up.
That's just kind of
squishing sense.
Okay.
I want to go
so,
get a squishy in my head.
We're starting to get into dextra territory.
Guys.
The point here is the way that we solve the equation, the way we approach the problem, though it may look like the choice between this scary trench and this nice calm above the trench, it turns out that above the trench is harder than you thought that it would be, right? Those fish knew it, school of fish knew it, okay, and now they know it. If they listened to the fish, then they would swim through the trench and maybe looked up and saw, oh, well, look at what we avoided, okay? So, this is again, I've just given you this piece of advice many times, and I want you to understand that I know what I'm talking about. I'm like that school of fish, I see what's coming, I know what's over the trench, it looks great, but it's not so great, okay? Swim through the trench with me, learn something that's a little bit difficult right now, but actually it turns out it's the shortcut in the long run, okay? So, let's talk about that.
Well, I was
going
to say, but
Dora's
not very smart. She has
short-term
memory loss. Yeah.
She does have a medical condition. So, even though the solution is correct, what mistake is Athena making here? That's a girl's name.
Athena.
We don't need to worry about what the else is. Tiana, what mistake is Athena making here?
Well, she's doing it right, yeah, but I completely forgot what I was going to say.
Zach?
She forgot to show her work.
I don't know, I mean, she's trying to show her work in red there, but her work doesn't really match what she got, even though she got the right answer. Yes? Okay.
She was supposed to divide by 5, not times 5.
She was supposed to divide by 5. No, I'll just say that. She's not supposed to divide by 5. That wouldn't help us at all. Jackson?
Maybe this multiplying by 5 is x as it is.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's supposed to be a 1 or a reciprocal.
Okay, so
that's
don't multiply by 5 over x. Instead, multiply by 5 over
1.
Okay, but I saw a lot of this, like there's an x there, and then magically, there's the right answer. Which means the person did not do what they. What their work showed, either that happened, or they didn't understand what they were showing. They kind of remembered what they were supposed to do. They saw the answer is obviously 35, because 35 divided by 5 is 7. Okay? And they just gave the answer. Okay. But that's swimming over the trench. You're just like, I didn't see the answer 35. Why don't I just give you the answer 35? Because later, and not much later, the answer is a decimal. Like, we're going to need a better way to approach this problem, okay? So, they kind of remember there was this multiplying by 5 over something. Now, let's talk about what would happen if this person actually, if Athena actually multiplied by 5 over x. How do we multiply fractions?
Straight across.
Straight across. So across the top, we would get?
5x.
And on the denominator, we would get?
5x.
5x over 5x. Okay, on the other side? Well, this is 7 over 1, so we would get 35, that should be an equal sign, over
one.
X. 1 times X is X. What's 5X over 5X?
5X.
We have 1 equals 35 over X. Well, now X is in the denominator?
Yeah.
Oh, that's frustrating. This person did not do what their work said that they were going to do, right? What they should have done, which what would make their answer and their work match up, is if they put a 1 here instead of an x. That it happens a lot. Like I'll see 3x equals 9, and the person will divide by. What do you think they divide by?
X.
X or 3x. Something with x. There's no need to divide by anything with x. Just divide so that the number becomes a 1. Don't divide by x. Okay. So forget about that. Let's back up. So if we do this with a 1 instead, let's see what happens now. Let's see what happens now. 5 times x is. 5x, very good. And 1 times 5?
5.
5 in the denominator, that seems a little better. On the other side, we have 7 times 5?
35.
Now, 5x over 5, what's that?
5x.
It's
1x. 1x, yes, exactly. 1x, thank you. Exactly. Very good. X, 1x is 35. Okay? 1x equals 35, or x equals 35. Okay. So look at the next one. Another person trying to swim over the trench, not through the trench. 42 equals 6x. Okay. Now, I'm writing a bunch of silliness here. I want you to tell me over here, how does Kingsley use algebra to solve the equation? Okay. Write in your notes how Kingsley uses algebra to solve the equation. You can tell me how Kingsley uses algebra to solve this equation. Kaden?
She had the right answer.
How did Kingsley use algebra to solve the equation? Algebra to solve the equation.
She divided by x.
It's hard to know what she means by x. Right? What she means by 6. What she means by ice cream? What she means by happy faces. What does she mean? What is she doing with these? Yeah.
I don't know. This is probably wrong, but I was just looking at it, and I looked at there's 4 going down and then 2 across, and a few. Never mind. Don't know where I'm going.
Okay. The point of all this is people don't normally put this kind of stuff, but they put a bunch of stuff that, if you're really trying to use some algebra, it's a bunch of nonsense. It's a bunch of numbers that you know are in the equation, you know they're related to the equation. You're supposed to do something with those numbers, but you're not quite sure what they are, and you haven't bothered to take the time to understand what you're supposed to do with those numbers. And what did somebody say? I asked, how did Kingsley use algebra to solve this equation? I think Zachary said it.
She divided on both
sides. She divided by x.
It's almost a trick question. What's that? Yeah.
She didn't
use algebra to solve this equation. You were right. She did not use algebra. Algebra is the practice of manipulating both sides of the equation the exact same way until x is by itself, numbers are on the other side, right? That's algebra. Kingsley used no algebra. What did Kingsley do? How did she probably, or is it he? Kingsley's a boyfriend, I guess, or it could be a girlfriend. So what did Kingsley do to actually solve this equation, find the solution to this equation? Emma?
They kind of copied it off some of the papers and then just wrote down the stuff to make it look like they did it.
They could have. They might have copied. I'll choose to think they're not so sinister, Kayla.
They might have done mental math.
Just some mental math, right? What did they ask themselves what?
6 times.
6 times something is 42.
6 times 4.
They know their multiplication facts. 7 is the number that x would have to be, right? 6 times 7 is 42. Just can see it, right? And that's what I hear from students. They can just see the answer, all right? And I understand what you're saying. That's true. But this answer is easy.
Shh.
This answer is very easy. 6 times 7 is 42. But what about 6x equals 13? There's not a nice number that 6 times that number is 13. There is a number that exists. What kind of number is it? Decimal, fraction, something. Like, it's not a nice number. It's not an integer, it's not a whole number. Okay. So, just use as an example, 6x equals 13, how would we solve for x in that case? Just shout it out.
Divide by 6
on both sides. Divide by 6 on both sides. Divide by 6. 6 divided by 6 is 1. We have x equals
6.5.
6.5. don't think it's 6.5.
0.65.
Two.
Wait.
And it should be 2.1
maybe? 2.16
repeating. Yeah. 1, 6, 1, just 1, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. 1, so like 1, 6 repeating. Just the 6 is repeating. Okay. 13, 6. So 2 and 1/6.
Oh.
Right. That's the answer. And probably are not going to just come up with that from looking at it. I mean, if you could, I'll make another equation. The answer is just a little bit harder. Like at some point, the solution is not obvious. It's not easy. So establishing these practices, right, is just barely getting into the trench. Come into the trench. Stop trying to swim over it. Go through it. Okay. While it's still easy, all right, follow everybody else in. All go through it together. We'll all learn some algebra, all right? And then next year, in full-blown algebra, you'll be that much more ready, and you won't have spent a year avoiding the trench and just saying, well, in my eighth grade class, most of the time I could just see the answer. It's because in your eighth grade math class, the answers were more obvious. Right? When they get less obvious, it gets more difficult. Okay.
You gotta figure out less obvious something.
Oh, well, I do it. Here we go. The catch here is we have multiple instances of the variable. Right? So let's just follow our instincts. What do you think you might start by doing? Someone besides someone who's already seen this.
But I haven't done it.
You haven't?
No.
What were you doing yesterday?
Oh, wait, yeah, I did. Oh. This is when we do on the computer, isn't it?
Lane? Yeah.
You put the x's by each other?
Put the x's by each other, 5x minus 3x plus 6. Haven't really done anything except for just move things around, which is not a bad idea. Yes?
Subtract
3x
from
5x. Okay, 5x minus 3x is what?
2x.
2x.
What's that mean?
3?
No.
If we use a number line, we would see that 5x is about there. This is 0. We're going to subtract 3x. 1, 2, 3x puts us here at
2x.
So 2x plus 6 equals 24. Okay. Not looking for you to guess and check and plug numbers in for x until something works. We're going to solve using algebra. Zach?
You would subtract 6 on both sides.
Subtract 6 on both sides, we get 2x is equal to 18. And then, JC.
If you divide by 2 on both sides,
x is 9. Okay. Same thing here, right? We're just going to come. So the trick here is we combine like terms, and that's like the first thing that we do. And then once we do that, then it just looks like our good friend, the two step equation. 1.2x minus 5.3x is negative, I'm not very good at my feet with that kind of stuff. 1.2 minus 5.3, negative 4.1x, plus 9, equals 12. Right? Now what? What do we do next? JC?
Subtract 9.
I will do myself a favor and not write that. Okay. So 12 minus 9 is going to be 3. Now we have 4.1 times x equals 3, and so how would we get x by itself? A 1x. Move this.
You
would
add
4.1
on each side.
Add 4.1. Because it's negative 4.1.
Divide
by negative 4.1 on both sides. Okay, and of course, I don't think anybody knows off the top of their head what 3 divided by negative 4.1 is, but on the calculator, we might. So when I have a scientific calculator, I like to just do 3 divided by 4.1. I know it's going to be negative, so just make it negative. Negative 0.7317. Okay? X equals, we're not done, stop packing up. Now we have this equation. Kaden, what do your instincts tell you you might start with on this equation? Left one.
Like terms together. Wait, no. 1.5 times 2D.
Just 1.5 times 2D?
And 1.5 minus times minus 1.
What do we call that?
Distributing.
Yes. 5 plus 1.5 times 2 is 3D. 1.5 times negative 1 is negative 1.5 equals 0.5. No like terms for the D, just 3D, but 5 minus 1.5 is what? 3.5 equals 0.5. And subtract 3.5 from both sides. Negative 3, divide by 3, what do we get?
1.
One. Negative 3 divided by 3.
Negative 1.
Okay, so there's combining like terms, and there's distributing as a part of solving an equation. You're just going to throw in those two things out there as well.
Okay?
Right now, no. Just hold on to it. We'll alternate it at the same time, whenever that is. Brandon.
So you take the test, can I come in at lunch?
Yeah. I'll sign that in just a second.